Hello everyone. Yesterday we discussed about the PCM, DPCM and delta modulation, adaptive delta modulation. I am your teacher Asif Saeed Khan. Today we have two topics. First one is white noise or additive white Gaussian noise, and second one is pre-emphasis, de-emphasis in the FM systems. So first we take white noise. What is white noise? It's a random process. What is random process? Random process is just a combination of various random variables, and that work in some specific conditions. So white noise is often used to model the thermal noise in electronic system. First we tell what is noise. Noise is the unwanted form of energy which is interrupted or interfere in the any signal. So what is thermal noise? Thermal noise which is generated in electronic system by the motion of electrons, atoms and others. So the white noise is a model which is used for thermal noise in electronic system. So by definition, the random process XT is called white noise if power spectral density of this random process is constant for all frequencies, but by convention this constant is denoted as N0/2. What is N0? N0 is the noise power. So the random process XT is called a white noise process if X power spectral density XSF is N0/2 for all the frequencies. So this is the definition of white noise. So further we going, we just calculate the expected power of the random process XT, and we find that it comes to infinity. So it means white noise by definition above the have the infinite power. But in reality, white noise is in fact an approximation of noise that is observed in the real system. Okay, so just we take the next diagram. Here is the two diagram A and B. First diagram represent the power spectral density of thermal noise, and second diagram represent the power spectral density of white noise. Here we see that both for the particular range, frequency range of our interest, from some millimeter wave to some giga millimeters wave, from few hertz to gigahertz, which is commonly used for communication system, this power spectral density of thermal noise as well as white noise is approximately constant. So here is the description. In part A, figure shows the real power spectral density of thermal noise, and here we see that out of the frequency range of interest, it's not constant for all other frequencies. So however, it is approximately constant over the frequency range that we are interested in. So in other word, in real time system, we normally use the band limited system signals and work in a limited range of frequency. So for that particular case, these both two are power spectral density of thermal noise and white noise is approximately same. The thermal noise in electronic system is usually modulated as a white Gaussian noise process. Gaussian, it means in a normal communication system or electronic system, we just approximated the distribution of noise as a Gaussian, and it's constant to all the components, so it's called white, and it's additive nature. It means its noise component, which is distributed in Gaussian form, is added to the each signal amplitude component constantly. So it is usually assumed that it has a zero mean, mu x is equal to zero, and distribution is Gaussian. So the definition comes. The random process XT is called a white Gaussian noise process if XT is a stationary Gaussian random process with zero means and flat power spectral density. So the same definitions for white Gaussian noises comes, but the some addition is it has zero mean and its distribution is stationary Gaussian and the power spectral density is flat. Okay, then we come to the next. Since the PhD of a white Gaussian noise is given by n not by 2, so we just calculate the autocorrelation function of this. Then we find that the autocorrelation function is n not by 2 del of tau, where del of tau is your direct delta function. It is defined as and del x is infinity when x is 0 and 0 otherwise. So then we go to some conclusion. This is again confirmed that the white Gaussian noise has infinite power, and if we calculate its expected value, which is same as the autocorrelation, so we also note that the Rx tau is 0 for any when tau is not equal to 0. This means that there is two process, random process, xt1 and xt2 are uncorrelated if t1 is not equal to t2. Therefore, for a white Gaussian noise, xt1 and xt2 are independent for any t1 is not equal to t2. So this white Gaussian noise process we also describe as a derivative of Brownian motions, and Brownian motion is we discuss in later. Then we come to our next topics, pre-emphasis and de-emphasis, which is used in the FM system. Before going with detail, we define pre-emphasis. Pre-emphasis refer to boosting the relative amplitude of the modulating voltage for the higher audio frequency from 2 to approximately 15 kilohertz. The reverse process, de-emphasis, means attenuating those frequency by amount by which they are boosted at the detector side. So however, pre-emphasis is done at the transmitter and de-emphasis is done at the receiver. The purpose is to improve the SNR of FM reception. A time constant of 75 microsecond is specified for the RC or LZ network for pre-emphasis and de-emphasis. So pre-emphasis, this is the circuit of pre-emphasis where RC network is combined, and the noise suppression ability of FM decreases with the increasing of the frequency. Thus, increasing the relative strength or amplitude of the high frequency component of the message signal before modulation is termed as the pre-emphasis. So here is the circuit. When the signal comes, then this R1, R2 and capacitor circuit is boosting the higher frequency component amplitude level before they're going to frequency modulator. Then the reverse process is come at the side of de-emphasis. In de-emphasis circuit, by reducing the amplitude level of the received high frequency signal by the same amount as the increasing pre-emphasis is termed as de-emphasis. So after the demodulation of FM signal, de-emphasis RC circuit is come, and it will attenuate the amplitude level of the higher frequency component and convert it same as the sending at the transmitter side. So in de-emphasis circuit, in the pre-emphasis process is done at the transmitter side, while the de-emphasis process is done at the receiver side. Thus, a high frequency modulating signal is emphasized or boost in amplitude in transmitter before modulation. To compensate this boost, the high frequency alternate or de-emphasis at the receiver after demodulation has been performed. Due to pre-emphasis and de-emphasis, the signal to noise ratio at the output of the receiver is maintained constant. The de-emphasis process ensures that the high frequency are returned to their original relative level before amplification. Pre-emphasis circuit is a high pass filter or differentiator which allow high frequencies to pass, whereas the de-emphasis circuit is a low pass filter or integrator which allow only low frequencies to the pass. So thank you for these two topics and